In order for genetic risk scores to go from the lab to the clinic, I think that we need to do a better job in terms of constructing these risk scores. We have to validate them as well. We're actively investigating how useful polygenic risk scores can be in the prediction of osteoporosis and fracture. The single biggest known risk factor is bone mineral density, and that's a very heritable trait.
Early predictors of disease are obviously most useful if you can do something about it. In the case of having a higher risk for high levels of cholesterol, for example, you could follow that up with an actual cholesterol test or take medication like statins.
In psychiatry, we often have a scenario where a patient has an unclear diagnosis, or in effect, where psychiatrists and mental health workers are waiting for their diagnosis to become clear. During this time, the patients tend to be on unnecessary drug medications or they're on the wrong drug medications. We're using polygenic risk scores to derive algorithms that will allow clinicians to better identify those patients who will go on and develop schizophrenia, for example, at an earlier date, and thus treat them more effectively.
癌の分野においても、その早期発見のための検査の頻度ですとか、といったものがそのリスクに応じて変わってくるとすると、癌も非常に有力なターゲットなのかなというふうに考えております。
Polygenic risk scores will have a role in clinical medicine, and it will be partly in preventative medicine, and ultimately perhaps in identifying which treatments an individual should be given as a priority.